Your customers want to select from the list of delicious bakery items of your store. An order form lets your customers directly send their orders to you. It is important for them to see the total amount and the order summary before they submit their orders. Today, I will show you how to create an online order form with Google Forms and use Neartail add-on to add dynamic calculations and order summary to Google Forms. Google Forms is a great choice to build online forms. It is simple and easy to create an online order form, but you can't add calculations to Google Forms. So you can't show order total on your form to your customers before they submit. In this video, I will get you started with the bakery order Google Form template. In three steps, I will show you how to customize it to suit your bakery business and to add dynamic calculations and order summary. Trust me, managing your bakery will now be a piece of cake. Step 1. Copy template or create your order form in Google Forms. I start with a ready-made bakery order Google Form template from Neartail's website. I make a copy of this template. This is not just a Google Form but already added with total amount and order summary formulas using Neartail add-on. So I will quickly show you a preview of how it works in the real time. You can use your own Google Form if you have already made one for your business. Watching this video further will help you understand how I use this ready-made template to use Neartail add-on to add calculations to your Google Forms. I click on the add-on icon, select Neartail, and click on Customize this form. If you haven't installed Neartail yet, you might have to install it first to make it work. This is the Neartail app's customization screen. As you can see, it is already partially customized into a two-column layout form. There are little gear icons for almost all the form elements, which lets me customize each one of it. You may want to play around with these to discover many customizations like changing the layout of the form, adding different styles and colors using CSS, etc. To see the preview, I click on Share. I get a short URL of this form, which I can share with my users. I open this URL to see that the Google form is neatly rendered into a web order form. I go ahead and select some of my favorites. Sure, I can't start with just one, so I order some cookies and cupcakes. Here you can see that the total amount is calculated here and the order summary is dynamically changing. If you have missed the magic moment, I will show you again. I add two numbers of apple and caramel crumble cupcake and you can see that the total amount and summary is changing automatically. Awesome, right? Step 2. Define or check prices for your products in a standard format to calculate the total amount. Now, you must be interested in where the formulas are written and how to write it, right? Let's go back to the customization screen. You need to do this from your Google Forms. You have to click on the add-on menu to access the customization screen. First, let's look at the total amount formula. I click on the gear icon next to the total amount. On the side panel, I see the answer tab, where I have the formula in the calculate option. It says total of dollar in double quotes. The dollar symbol here is your currency. As you have seen in this order form template, the prices of all the bakery goods are defined in American dollars. So in this formula here, you mention the currency symbol that is used in the prices. If you are from France, your prices may be in euros. So you can define total of euro in this formula here. Now that you have seen the total amount calculated like magic, I am sure you understand the trick is to define the prices of each product in a specific way. You are right. The price is defined in the question description and there is a syntax that you need to follow. This is to allow Neartail to know how to use this information to calculate the total amount and order summary. So here is how you will do it. First, you have to let Neartail know the currency that you use followed by the price in the first word of the description. The second part after a space is to write special mentions like whether the price is for per piece or per pack or per kilo. For example, for the choco chip cookies, it is $0.95 each. It is simple, but it has to be followed consistently for all your products. Step 3. Add order summary. In the review and place your order section, you can see that there is a special instruction added. It reads, please review your order carefully before submitting it for processing. If you click on the gear icon here, you can see where this extra line is added from. Here, you can add or change the description for a question that you had in Google Forms. Apart from the special instruction, you can see a formula, summary of true, comma, true, which is enclosed within a dollar symbol and curly braces. Just to make things clear, the dollar symbol here has nothing to do with your currency symbol, but it is a part of the formula syntax that you need to use irrespective of which currency you deal with. So it starts with a dollar, open curly braces, summary. Within that, it takes two parameters. The first, true or false, is to say whether to add the total of list of items in the summary that you're going to show for your user. The second, true or false, is to say whether to add totals of items across all your sections. For example, if you have many sections, like one section for bakery items, the other section for pastries, maybe you want to calculate the total across both the sections, so you may want to use true. So here we have used summary with both parameters true. You may want to change these options to suit your needs. There we go. This brings to the end of how this order form template works. Now you can customize it as you want with the list of items that you sell at your store. Just one tip before I leave you to work. Don't forget to add the top sellers in the top of your list. Your customers will love it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please ask us anytime at neartail@guesswork.co if you have any questions. Once you're successful with your forms, please share with us the URL of your form in the comments section below. We will be more than happy to see your beautiful forms. See you soon.